Hello, my name is Bob Vernon, and I'm the founder of Big Chief Entertainment, LLC. We're going to take a few moments to show you why we chose iClone as the software of choice for our Quest for Megalodon movie. And we're very honored to have Reelusion and iClone 5 as our technology and content sponsors. Here's a few reasons why we love iClone.
Stefano De Carli, I am the director of animation for the Quest for Megalodon project. Today I just like to show you some technique and some tricks that I am using for the production of the movie.
I started using iClone in 2006 when I found out that you can create your own faces on your avatar.
One of the tools I like the most in iClone 5 is the atmosphere settings. In this case I'm just using a fog setting to show the shark coming from right of the screen and disappearing again to the left behind these rocks that we're seeing on the screen. And this also helps to give you a sense of danger, you know, an expectation.
Again, I am using the fog effects for this close-up of the shark. You can get great results using just one light. This is another example of using HDR lights in iClone. As you can see, the avatar is walking and we see the sun rays on the upper part of the frame, and the lights are behaving just like in real world environment. So in the end, we see the silhouette of the avatar, you know? In this case, we have a sunrise scene, so one light is more than enough to show the sun coming up behind the boat and behind the avatar.
Another advice I'd like to give you is this: always carry with you a little digital camera, because everything you see can become a great texture for iClone.
Another feature that I really like is the depth of field, and that way you can achieve cinematic results.
I just want to thank Reelusion for the great support and great help they're giving us for the production of the movie. I just can't wait to show you the final result, which will be great. And in the meantime, as we say here in Italy, arrivederci.
My name is Carl Weldon. I'm a voice actor and performance artist. It's been a challenge to come up with new characters, but some of them are just like putting on a costume. And I love bringing it into life. I've been fortunate enough to see the results later on down the line. And, you know, it's always fun to hear your voice coming out of an animated character. It's like wearing another skin. July 19th, 1987. It's our ninth day at sea. Impeccable weather has prevailed. Clear skies and virtually no wind. Characters probably my whole life. I mean, as a little kid, I would be, you know, making noises and such, you know, whatever it might be. But I started training voice in high school, learning singing classical music. And then in the mid-90s, I did a few radio spots, and I said, this is something I'd really like to get into. And as the millennium rolled around, I turned pro.
And we're sure it's more than a rumor. Severe shortages in silver are coming up. The brothers have been picking it up a few hundred contracts at a time, but they're about to get really serious.
What's the timing? How soon do I need to get in?
Got a home studio here. I've got a Shure SM7B. It's a standard in a lot of broadcast environments here. Great for when you don't have an acoustically perfect place. So if you're into voice work and don't have a studio that's soundproof, it's a good choice. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pan the camera over and we'll look at what I've got it running through.
We'll be back up as quick as we can.
Hey, this is the Art Voice Channel Tube Preamp. It's a channel strip with all kinds of wonderful gadgets and gizmos in it, a little bit of everything. You can dial it in, but what's great about it is it's digital connectivity. I can hook it up to just about anything, and it's got a nice fat bunch of features that help me sound oh so good. There's a Telefunken tube swapped in there for all you tech heads who like to know what's inside the guts of these things.
Me? I don't give a gnat's ass for these Buck Rogers contraptions. Zero results, too.
And the wonderful thing about it is most people have, you know, a little microphone for their Skype work and came with a computer. It doesn't sound so great, but if you get a nice VO rig going, it makes a difference.
Well, that looks like it's in pretty good shape for a PR piece. Well, let's see. Do we have enough rendering power to render this little baby out? Yeah. I think that's gonna work. Okay, here we go.
Come on, Skipper, can't we fish just a little longer? Just till the sun's up. A few more minutes can't hurt anything. Okay, Joe, but we pick him up at 7 sharp. Been a long night, and I got family coming for dinner at noon. Gonna drop the frequency a little for that last minute, Skipper. Man, take a gander at that sunrise. Talk about gorgeous. My brother-in-law Charlie would probably love the shit out of this damn gadget. Me? I don't give a gnat's ass for these Buck Rogers contraptions. Zero results, too. Sure thought this frequency would turn up at least a shark or two. Looks like someone's getting an early start. Must be dolphin fishing. I think that's Doc Smith's boat from the Shape of Her Hull. Probably that boy, his and some of his buddies. Bunch of fishing nuts. Hell, Fishy, it just don't get no better than this. Only if that crazy fish finder of yours will attract something decent in the next few minutes. Fishy?